Welcome to the Daily Stock Report, brought to you by QualityStocks.net, Performance Track Daily. I'm Brooke Van Leer, and for our Thanksgiving weekend report, we're bringing you the latest news from around the markets, as well as the top movers to look out for today. In our headline news, Wall Street drifted to a slightly higher finish Tuesday as investors shied away from taking new positions in a holiday-shortened week. Investors' hesitation came after Wall Street snapped a six-session winning streak on Monday, concerned that a recent run-up has driven some stocks too high. No big moves were expected before Thanksgiving, although retailers remain in focus ahead of one of the biggest shopping days of the year on Friday. But investors still put more money into the nation's number one search engine. Despite the market's languid tone, Google surpassed $500 for the first time. Google rallied more than 2% on a new record, hitting an intraday high of $509.88. Shares have soared since the public priced its initial public offering at $85 a share in August of 2004. Boeing led the Dow Jones Industrials after the aerospace company received a $5.5 billion order for planes from Korea Airlines Company. Broader stock indicators also edged higher. The Standard & Poor's 500 Index was up 1.6%, and the NASDAQ Composite rose 0.9%. Bonds edged higher with a yield on a benchmark 10-year Treasury note falling to 4.5% from 4.6% on Monday. The dollar was mixed against other major currencies, while gold prices rose. In small cap news, Digital Youth Network Corporation announced today that it has entered into a licensing agreement with Universal Music Canada, wherein DY Mobile will promote and sell Real Music ringtones, also known as MP3 True Tones, to mobile subscribers on Canada's four largest wireless networks. Digital Youth Network has negotiated various revenue sharing agreements to publish mobile on-demand pages within publications across Canada. Mobile on-demand pages allow consumers on all four major Canadian wireless networks to purchase content such as Real Music ringtones and images for their mobile handsets. Digital Youth Network Corporation, previously at 8 cents, was up over 87% at 15 cents with 19,000 shares traded. Sen Group Petroleum Corporation was developed to take advantage of an opportunity to recover surface oil in the Caspian Sea region and to reclaim the oil to productive use while environmentally restoring land, sea, and shore. It has been estimated that there are approximately 250 million barrels of surface lying oil on water and land in the Caspian Sea region, with nearly 1 million new barrels of oil leaking to the surface each year. Sen Group cleans the environment in two ways. First, by gathering materials used in everyday packaging and recycling them, and second, by using recycled material to reclaim oil. Sen Group Petroleum Corporation, previously at 4 cents, closed up over 75% at 7 cents with 67,000 shares traded. Multicell Technologies Incorporated develops primary cell immortalization technologies to produce cell-based systems used in drug discovery that have many valuable applications in treatment of deadly diseases, such as cervical cancer and other cancers that are caused by viruses. Multicell Technologies, previously at 26 cents, was up over 23% at 32 cents, with 500,000 shares traded. And that's it today for our newsmakers. Be sure to join us every market day for the latest market commentary on small cap to large cap and everything in between. Brought to you by QualityStocks.net. Also be sure to watch for the Quality Stocks Daily Newsletter, available each trading day through QualityStocks.net. Thank you for tuning in. I'm Brooke Van Leer. Have a great day, and we'll see you tomorrow, right here on the Daily Report. Happy Thanksgiving.
Transmission is coming to you.
You've got it.